Welcome to the NMR lab. Today I am going to start a series about scalar coupling. In a previous video, I discussed the effect of environment on the NMR resonant frequency, which is known as chemical shift. There's an additional effect. This causes frequency splitting called scalar coupling. It is also called spin-spin or J-coupling. For the time being, I will discuss spin half nuclei and mostly between protons.
The spin orientation of neighboring nuclei affects the effective magnetic field at a nucleus. There are two spin orientations for spin half nuclei. These orientations are effectively equally likely at normal temperatures, so the resonant frequency splits into two signals of equal height. The resonant frequency of the observed nucleus A is dependent on the spin alignment of the coupled nucleus X. A's signal is split into two equal parts because X is effectively equally divided between alignments. The coupling constant, or J, measures the splitting's size as an absolute frequency and is independent of the magnetic field. The coupling constant is usually measured in Hertz. The same coupling constant, even though it is the same number of Hertz, looks larger at lower magnetic fields on the chemical shift scale measured in ppm. This is because a lower magnetic field strength results in a lower resonant frequency. Therefore, on the chemical shift scale, in this instance, the 200 MHz multiplet looks wider than the 500 MHz multiplet. The number of splittings indicates the number of chemically bonded nuclei in the vicinity of the observed nucleus. If there is more than one nucleus, then there is extra splitting. The neighboring nuclei may have different coupling constants. Each splitting is different. One coupled nucleus splits it into two peaks, two nuclei four peaks, three nuclei eight peaks, etc. N coupled nuclei split the signal into as many as 2 to the power of n plus 1 signals. Other patterns exist depending on the coupling constants. If the coupling constants are the same as each other, the coupling patterns are different. The splitting is binomial, with one more line than the number of coupling nuclei. One coupled nucleus gives a 1-to-1 doublet. Two coupled nuclei lead to a 1-2-1 triplet. Three coupled nuclei lead to a 1-3-3-1 quartet, and so on, for 12 coupled nuclei giving a trideset of 13 signals. Other combinations of coupling constants lead to additional patterns. The magnitude of the coupling generally decreases with increasing number of and length of bonds separating the nuclei. One bond couplings are usually larger than two bond couplings that are often larger than three bond couplings. However, three bond and longer range couplings are dependent on other factors such as conformation. Three bond couplings depend on the dihedral angle, and longer range couplings are small and depend on conformation. A dihedral angle near 0 degrees or 180 degrees gives a larger coupling than for dihedral angles near 90 degrees. The simple first order coupling patterns that I have shown are distorted by second order effects. When the chemical shift separation becomes small compared to the coupling constant, for example, two coupled proton signals show height distortions as the chemical shifts approach each other, eventually merging into a single peak. Coupling between protons or between nuclei of the same type is called homonuclear coupling. Heteronuclear coupling is the coupling between different nuclei. A proton signal may be split by another proton or by a different nucleus, such as fluorine. Fluorine 19, phosphorus 31, and rhodium 103 are the only spin half nuclei with 100% natural abundance. Their coupling to protons looks the same as homonuclear coupling, such as one fluorine splits a proton signal into two peaks. Other spin half nuclei have lower natural abundances. These include carbon 13, 1.1%, nitrogen 15, 0.37%, and silicon 29, 4.7%. They manifest themselves as satellite signals. Many nuclei have spin greater than a half. One of these nuclei will split a proton signal into more than two peaks. For example, nitrogen 14 is spin 1 at near 100% abundance and splits a proton signal into 3.
In this video, I have introduced some of the characteristics of scalar coupling in NMR. There is much more to say, so in future videos we'll go into more depth. So if you like this video, then please subscribe, order service from the link below. Bye then!